guys, welcome back to Mommy and Flurry Tale, and today I'm back with another informative video for all the pet parents who are boarded to this channel. Thank you so much guys for subscribing, for sending me regular video requests and ideas. Keep on supporting me and motivating me this way, and do share this channel, my videos, with your friends and family in order to motivate them as well to get a pet and have a wonderful life. People who are watching me for the very first time, this is a channel of an Indian pet mom where I do share my lifestyle with this baby who is sleeping at my back right now. If you guys can see, she is Flurry. So without any further delay, let's jump on to today's topic. Today I'm gonna talk to you guys about ticks and fleas in dogs. It is a very serious and common concern among pet parents. So let me first tell you guys, what are these ticks and fleas? Ticks and fleas are basically the parasites which feeds on your pet's blood, and if not taken care of properly or on time, it can cause serious health issues in pets, starting from allergic reaction, skin infection, or even tick paralysis, the serious diseases like this in pets. This problem commonly seen mostly during the warmer months, and you have to be very careful about the prevention and cure. These parasites can be of many different shapes, size, and colors. For your convenience, I'm going to include a slide here which will help you guys to find out that how these ticks and fleas commonly looks like. Where do these ticks and fleas come from? So ticks and fleas can grow anywhere, especially in your backyards, in your garden area. Their favorite place to grow is long grass, shrubs, unruly part of your garden, or in the pile of garbage. So they can grow anywhere and everywhere. Even the brown color ticks, which is commonly known as American ticks, can grow inside your house, carpet of your house, inside your furniture, or the cracks of your walls, your bedding, your mattress. They can grow anywhere. How do our pet gets fleas? Since these fleas and ticks grow very commonly in the outdoor environment, as I said, anywhere and everywhere, so for our pets it becomes very easier to pick up fleas, especially when they are outdoors. So these ticks crawl through the grass and shrubs, and they wait for a host like your pet to pass by. They can wait for a year without feeding. Dogs are most likely to pick up these ticks while walking on the grass. They can also pick up fleas very easily if they come in contact with another pet who is infected with fleas and ticks. Female fleas can lay 40 to 50 eggs in a day. Even if one single female flea gets a chance to get into your pet's fur, it can lead to an infestation over the night. What happens when they reside onto your pet's body and they lay eggs on their body? If one or two eggs fall onto your bed or anywhere inside the house, that can infect your entire house very quickly. So what are the signs to know that whether your dog has actually picked up ticks or flea? So if you see the flea dropping and egg dropping signs on their body, what are those flea dropping signs? Looks like a cluster of black dust particle. And if you pick up with your hand, it will look like a small dust particle, but those are actually flea dropping signs. And you can also notice the same thing in white color, which are the egg dropping signs. And if you notice your pet is scratching their body a lot, or you are finding scabs or hot skin when you are petting them, and as soon as you notice this warning signs, you should start working on it immediately. So how dangerous these parasites are? As I said, if not taken care of properly, they can cause serious health issues in your pet. So one of the most serious issues which it can cause in your pet is anemia. A flea or tick can take 15 times of their own weight in blood. If one or more than one is residing on your pet's body, they keep on feeding on their blood, and that's the way our pet loses a lot of blood, and it can lead to a serious anemic situation, which is not desirable at all. It can also cause allergic reaction, because when they bite your pet, they inject their saliva into their blood, and that can lead to a serious allergic reaction to your pet. So the signs of this allergic reaction include wounds, itching, scabs, hot skins, or small red bumps on their skin. And the most dangerous fact about these parasites is they equally love human blood. As I mentioned before, that when they lay eggs, if one or two eggs drop onto your carpet or your bed, they can easily get into your body and they can feed on your blood as well. And just as in our pet, they can cause the serious allergic reaction to our skin as well. So that's the reason they are very, very important to be taken care of. So I have already discussed the warning signs of fleas and ticks in your pet, and when they're already in your pet's body, how to find them out. It's very easy to find the adult parasites because they are larger in size. While petting them or when you are combing them, if you feel something which is not their skin, you find something bumpy, first thing you should do is to take them out. And to do that, please use a gloves or a tissue, and with the help of a tweezer, just try to take that out from the sides or by its head, and pull them out straight. Don't twist it. Since they feed on your pet's blood, be very careful that you pull them out straight, and no way you should pop their bloated belly. So once you take them out, put them into a jar or put them onto a tissue and put some spirit or alcohol on it, it will die. Make sure before you flush them out, you do kill that parasite to ensure that it doesn't cause any more infestation inside your house. But how to take care of fleas and ticks in your pet? Taking care part I will divide into two segments. One is prevention and the other one is cure. So first I will talk about cure. So in case you find out your pet is already infected with ticks and fleas, by infected I do not mean only one or two ticks which you notice in their body every now and then. By infected I mean that if you see that the parasite has managed to multiply themselves in enormous number, when the situation becomes this serious, without experimenting, my suggestion would be to consult your vet, because considering the amount of infection, the vet is the best person to suggest whether a oral medication is required or a topical medication is enough. So that's about the serious infection. Now the normal regular cure is using a medicated shampoo. There are a lot of shampoos available in the market which controls ticks and fleas in your pet, but they don't prevent them coming into their body. They just take care of the parasites which are already residing in your pet's body. The regular use of this shampoo will gradually takes the number down of the parasites residing in your pet's body. Since they are medicated, they actually cause very rough hair. So I would suggest, even if you are using this medicated shampoo, don't use it regularly. If you are giving your pet shower 4 times a month, use it twice. The rest of the time you use the normal regular shampoo which you use. Or when you are selecting this medicated shampoo, be very careful about the ingredients which it has. Try to go for the organic or natural ones. That will not cause that much of roughness to their hair. You can also use a good conditioner after using this shampoo, which will take care of the softness of your pet's fur. There are specialized combs to take these fleas and ticks out from their hair is available all over the market and online, so you can find those out very easily, but I'm not really sure that how effective they are. I have never used them. Well, since they're available in the market, I'm sharing with you. And the next remedy which I'm gonna share with you guys is, according to me, is the most effective and also safe to use if you just keep 2-3 facts very clear in your mind. That is spot-on treatment. These spot-ons are insecticides which comes in the form of liquid in small tubes, and this is applied directly on the skin, usually over the shoulder blades or down the back. The active ingredients in these spot-ons is neurotoxins, which specifically targets the adult parasites. Few spot-ons comes with the ingredient which also prevents this larva to grow into an adult parasite, and the oily liquid in which the medication is dissolved helps it to spread all over the skin surface to the sebaceous gland. And this medication may kill as well as repel parasites. Where will you find these spot-ons and what are the facts you have to remember while you are administering this to your pets? You can find these spot-ons very easily available in any pet store. They are available online and they can be purchased without prescription. If you are purchasing this spot-on from your vet, or you are purchasing it online or from any other pet store, do mention your pet's exact body weight. Based on that, they will give you the medication, because the dosage of medication depends on the weight of your pet. It comes as 0 to 10 kilos, 11 to 20 kilos. It comes that way. So it is very important for you to mention your pet's body weight. You just need to part your pet's body fur into two parts. You need to administer it in a place where they will not be able to lick themselves. Best part is here, which is over the shoulder blade or down the back, where they cannot lick themselves, because these are insecticides and these are poisonous. It is very, very dangerous if your pet licks this medication. If you have a kid, or if you have another pet in home, a cat or another dog, you have to be very, very careful, at least for next 3 days since the time you apply, that they don't lick onto this medication, because it is equally poisonous for them. And while you are applying it, wear a glove, or once you apply, please wash your hands with a disinfecting cleaner to ensure your safety as well. The day you apply this medication, pre and post 3 days, your pet should not be given shower. This medication can be applied maximum once in a month, not more than that. For safety of your pet, do consult a vet and act according to his or her suggestion. Now let me talk to you guys about the prevention. The first step of prevention is keeping your pet and your house very clean and tidy. Do wipe their paws off very neatly. Also use this flea or ticks combs at least twice a week to comb their hair. Even if something comes inside, that you can take them out immediately. Even if your pet is not infected, you can use a good quality ticks and flea control shampoo once a month. The next thing, which is very, very important, to keep your pet's deworming updated and to keep their vaccination updated, because these are the natural immunity boosting process which you have to keep your pets updated on. And the next prevention is keep your house clean. As I said, that these parasites can even grow into your carpet, on your bedding, in the curtains of your house, and they love damp area. So use a good quality disinfecting floor cleaner. If not possible every day, at least for 2 to 3 times a week, wipe all your furniture well using a good disinfecting cleaner. Clean your carpets, curtains and beddings as frequently as possible. Keep your mattress out in the sun if possible once a week. So these are the steps, if you follow regularly, will help your make life easier and also will keep your house ticks and flea proof. End of this entire discussion, we all have understood that how dangerous this ticks and flea could be if not taken care of. Especially during the warmer months, if you see any abnormalities in your pet, that losing appetite, feeling lethargic, skin reactions, skin allergies, do consult your vet as soon as possible. Please do not ignore. So this discussion was not to scare you guys who are planning to get a pet or who already have a pet. And I think people who have pet, they know that it's a very common thing. All our pets pick up ticks and fleas at some point of time in their life. There is nothing to be so worried about. These are completely curable. These are just few very simple and regular steps which you need to take care of to ensure that you are maintaining a healthy, hygienic life for both of you, for a healthy living. When there is a problem, there is definitely a solution. That's what I believe in. And giving up is not an option. When you make a commitment to a life, you have to be ready and you have to be mentally prepared to take care of all the outcomes which it is gonna give to you guys for rest of your life, for the upcoming days. I wish you all a very, very happy parenting. Have a healthy and hygienic life with your pet. That's all I had, guys, to share with you all in today's video. I hope you guys found this video useful. In case you have any more question, do feel free to ask me in the comment section below. I will reply to each one of you. Do share this video with your friends and family in order to help them out too. In case you found this information useful, you know what to do, right? Hit the like button. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much. And in case you are watching me for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe. See you guys soon in my next video. Take care. Bye.
We love you all.